Okay, so here we are in the development environment, and as you can see, we have an option to create a project right here. So let's go ahead and click on that, and we can create it. So you might have already seen this in the database videos when we set up our database, but we're going to go through it again here. So we have different options here for creating some template projects, which would be good to explore, but for now we're going to create a blank one. Then we can name that project, whatever we want to name it. I'm going to name it GMS Inventory, like so. Pretty simple and straightforward. We can add a description, some additional information, as well as an icon for that too, and make it look a little bit nice if we wanted to. Go ahead and click next for now. And next is databases. So you saw this in the databases video, hopefully. So we're going to go ahead and set up our database when we create our application. So we have lots of different databases types here. We're going to choose MySQL and wait for that to load. And then we can set our connection name however we want it to be. I'm going to name it inventory, like so. Our driver is going to be the PDO driver for MySQL. Server is going to be a localhost with the default port as well. And then you can enter in your credentials for your database. So at this point, you've already created your database and you just need to enter in the credentials for your server's database. Then you can list your databases to see the databases you have access to. There's a global music inventory database. That's the database I created for this. And then you can go ahead and test your connection to make sure it is successful, and it is. So let's go ahead then and click next to go on to the next step of this process, which is languages. So once we click next, we have some options here to add different languages. So you have the language itself, the regional settings, we're in the United States, and then the char set for that as well. You can make the language default or delete a language, or you can add another language so that you can have multiple languages. When you go on to next, you can then choose the theme. So we have a lot of different themes in Scriptcase, and we have some nice new themes in Scriptcase 9, the latest version, that really allow us to present a really nice UI experience. We're going to do the sweet blue, so I'm going to do select the theme and then default. That's so that any applications created will automatically have that theme by default, and you can add multiple themes to the project as well if you want to get multiple different looks. So then we can click next, and we're going to go ahead and create our project. Everything is set up and our project is ready to go. Once that loads, we'll have access to our different application types. As you can see, so we have our grid, that's for displaying data, our chart, and then form for editing data. We have a control application, which is like a form, but not attached to a database necessarily. We have research for searching data. We have a menu application, as well as a tree menu application for linking different applications together. Tabs, PDF reports here. So tabs can have two applications, and then PDF reports are kind of like grids, but generates a PDF. We have dashboard for displaying multiple applications at once, a blank application, which can do pretty much anything we want, and then a calendar application. So let's go over and let's look at some samples for these before we get started so you can see what they do. So this is on the Scriptcase website under samples, and we have some different options here. So let's check with forms first. So we have a simple form, just a basic form, which is going to be pretty much what we need for most of this project. So as you can see, we have some different areas of this form here. We have employees and an address and some different form types. So here's a date field. We can save it, we can add a new one, we can copy it, we can export it, and we can search it as well. So lots of different options on just a simple form here. Let's go to reports and look at a grid. So here's a default grid, just a basic grid here. And as you can see, it's just lists the data. So we can choose which fields we want listed and do lots of different options here, but pretty simple. It's kind of the most simple of applications. We can determine which columns are there. We can export all these different options here. We can do some searching as well, just like on the form. So if you click search, you can go to an advanced search with lots of different options here on this grid. So that's how grids work. Let's go ahead and look at a chart application as well. So here's a bar chart. Click on that. Lots of different chart types here, and we'll explore those more when we start developing charts. But as you can see, just a basic bar chart displaying some data looks very nice, and it's very, very easy to create and customize. So these can be difficult if you're doing this by hand, but Scriptcase makes it very simple and easy. So then we've got dashboard applications. Dashboards are very useful. You can do a lot with them, make them look really nice and really impressive very easily, actually. So once we wait for that to load, as you can see, we can display multiple applications at once. So we've got two different applications side by side, a grid, and then a chart as well. Which looks very nice, and it's easy to display multiple bits of data in one place. Here's a menu. So here's a horizontal menu, As you can see, there's two areas on this menu. You have the main menu options here, and then you have some buttons here too. So you can do both of those on the menu. We're going to do just the main menu option in our menu as well with this horizontal menu. So you click on that and it loads it right below there in the menu, so the menu stays displayed as well. Then we've got some other applications here. So we've got tab applications. We're going to build one of those. So that's just so you can display multiple applications and just have them in different tabs here. So I've got a grid and a form here set up, so it's easy to access them both at the same time, as you can see. And then under programming, we've got some more options here, but we've also got a calendar under other applications. So I want to show you that. We're going to set up a calendar and integrate it with Google Calendar as well. So as you can see, here's a calendar. We can click something. We can add an event. It pops up a form here, and we can select the date and the end date and time as well. Then under programming, we've got a blank application here. So lots of different options for programming. We're not going to get into all of them. But if you look at blank applications here, it's just really a place to put some code doing whatever we want. So here's a little bit more complex one using a jQuery plugin to display some different options here. If we go back to forms, I want to show you a control application as well, which also involves some programming as well. So if we scroll down to the bottom under control, we've got a registration form. So a control is kind of like a form, except it's not necessarily attached to a specific database table. So as you can see, you've got a very nice UI here for entering in some user information and some different buttons, and you can control that all programmatically. So those are our different application types in Scriptcase. So those are most of them, and we'll get started pretty soon here with creating some different applications for our project.